Welcome back to my YouTube channel, everybody. I have a plant and pot haul for you today. So this may be quite niche, but if you love the plants and the pots, yeah, I think you'll like this little haul. So I popped up like a garden declutter and clear out video just on Thursday. So this is just like a little bonus video. And this week I went to like a couple of garden centers locally and the kids were off school for Easter and I couldn't like, you know when you like need it to be quiet? I'm the sort of person that will go to first thing and go somewhere when there's going to be no people. So I can get in my pot purchasing zone. And yeah, that's what I did. Was too busy on Sunday. I got like a bit of compost and I planted just a few bits in the garden, but I was like, no, I need to go during the week when it's quiet. So that's what I did. I actually went yesterday and behind me I've got a flower pot haul. Now what I will say is I don't generally, you know, when I do a haul video I try and have it like, you know, thrifted or secondhand, or I try not to promote the whole buy culture, except with plants and pots, because when I buy plants and pots, nature, the birds, the bees, the insects, all benefit from it. So I see it as a positive. Anyway, I'm gonna put my tea down and I think I'm gonna start with pots. Just, I made my tea extra sugary, which isn't good, but you know, it's good. Okay, so I love terracotta pots, clay pots, and they're really cheap as well and they're great for DIYs. And you can like do effects where you age them and you make them look older, but to be honest, just leave them in the garden and nature will do its thing. But I just think they are so like rustic, and if I had a greenhouse I would make it look really like Italian or Parisian with all the clay pots on the wall and your little seed tray and stuff. But hey, one day for the greenhouse. But I'm gonna start off, I got, it's very echoey. So I got this longer one because I actually got some ranunculus, and I think the ranuncula, if I'm saying that right, is like my new favorite flower. They're kind of like a late spring, midsummer flower. And I got three. I think they're perennial. I hope they're perennial. If not, I'll take seed, but I think they're perennial. So I got this wider tray to pop them in. Anything I have, the thing with garden stuff is you'll notice the same stuff in most garden centers, like terracotta pots, you'll pick them up on Amazon. So anything I have here is from local garden centers, but just have kind of a look on Amazon and you should be able to get them in yours because they have kind of similar stuff. So I got this wide one and then I got a load of like this size. So I got eight of, right, there should be, so these little ones I was thinking for my seedlings. So I've got some delphiniums and dahlias on the windowsill, and to transplant them I do hang on to the plastic containers from the plants that I buy, but also like terracotta pots are great because I have a border at the front of the garden but I have no borders in the back garden, so I use a lot of pots. And these ones were €1, and what size are these? This is a 13.6, so like a 14 centimeter diameter pot. These ones were only €1, and then the other ones were 150, and the diameter of them is 15.5. So 15.5, and I got 8 of each of them. So just your terracotta pot. I also bought these little ones because they were cute and I thought they would be cute for a DIY. They were only like €3 for 8, and the diameter, they are 6 centimeters. And again, I was thinking for some seedlings, which I have some indoor houseplant seeds, and I thought that these little clay pots would look cute on the window but also serve a purpose for the little seedlings. So I'll share them. And then I also got, I try to recycle the plastic trays. So I know like plastic has a bad name for itself, but they do last. So any of the like plastic seed trays that I have had for previous years, I just try and recycle them. And then if I have to buy new, I'll buy the kind of more eco-friendly ones. So these ones, I just picked up a couple of these. I have most of my seeds kind of planted. I'm not really doing, I have some strawberries, but aside from that, I'm not doing veg this year. I'm focusing more on like bee-friendly plants and cut flowers in the garden. So I got this set of fiber pots for seeds, and it just says, I reckon you can put these into the ground and they decompost. So place seeds or cuttings in each pot, cover with a layer of compost, place in right position. Yeah, don't allow it to dry out. Yeah, no root disturbance, plant straight into the ground when the roots appear through the side of the pot. You can also use toilet rolls. I think I had a video last year sharing how to fold your toilet roll. The only thing with them is sometimes they can become a bit lopsided, but they're absolutely grand. So toilet rolls and newspaper is also a great way if you need to make things for seedlings. So that's another thing you can do, or just recycle your kind of plastic containers. So the things that come with the plants in the shop, I try to reuse them and hang on to them. Okay, I got two big sexy pots. I have a thing for ceramics, whether it's a teapot, teacup, flower pot, I'm all over that. So these are heavy. I got two of these, one each. So last year I started getting pots like this. There's a brand. Oh, the tag is off because I pulled the tag off for the girl to scan. You notice this brand or this style of pot in like most garden centers. And I have like I kind of collect them, to be fair. But I have two hookers. Hey there, I sound like I'm saying a hooker. I have two hookers. I'm getting giddy now. And so basically my two hookers survived. Like when a plant decides to come back, I'm like, we reward living in my garden. So I decided they need bigger pots. The poor lads are squashed. It's like having shoes that don't fit, having a pot too small. So in order for them to grow, I got my girls two pots. I got a lovely purple one last year for the olive tree because I watched Gardener's World and Monty Don was sharing how to repot your olive tree. And he was like, you can repot them like every 5 years, and he was repotting his. So I got mine a lovely big pot so that it would grow into it. So I try and go like, when I can, bigger with the pot. So if I see a little flower and it's starting to struggle, it's time for a bigger pot. And I like pots, especially in the back garden, because you can move them around. I notice I have a flower bed out the front, and it's because that area was all like gravel and it was so dirty when I moved in years ago. And that's a lovely border and flower bed now, but it's harder to move the flowers. So if a flower is not doing well, you kind of have to wait until it finishes flowering to move it. So the thing with pots is, if I notice someone is getting too much sun, I'll just move them and they can go out the front or out the back. And also another thing, my brother as well does the mess, and he's like, does nobody rob your pots? And no, touch wood now, nobody robs or steals my flower pots. Like, it would be a really nasty, mean thing to steal someone's pots, but apparently that's a thing, people robbing people's pots and plants. I just feel like that's something you'd go to hell for. I mean, robbing someone's house is one thing, but robbing their pots and their plants, come on. Anyway, no, they don't steal them, but if they do, I'd be very upset, wouldn't I? But yeah, so that, I got two of them anyway. Now, just randomly in my hall, because I love feeding the birds, and I actually noticed there's two robins now. I don't know if they're a couple, because it is kind of, I notice it's mating season in the garden, and the pigeons are chasing each other, and the magpies, there's like two. They look like they're breaking twigs off the tree to make a nest. And I've loads of little birds, and love is definitely, is that where that phrase come from? Because love is definitely in the air in my garden. I can see them all like making nests and chasing each other. So I love feeding the birds, but I've started, I either get the fat balls or I get seed or both. And see these plastic containers, these are great when they're empty for collecting rainwater for flower pots to water them. So when clay pots dry out much quicker than other pots, So what I do is when this is like, I recycle the container and I keep them, and you'll notice like the birds will start like bathing in them, but I just dunk the flower pot into the bucket of water. Let the, if there's any like air bubbles, I let them come out and then take it out. So it's better than like watering with a hose or a watering can. I just dunk the flower pot into water. And I think I've seen that on Gardener's World. And also years ago as a kid, I noticed my dad would do it. There would be like a big rain tank, like a water butt, and he would always just be dunking plants in and like watering them that way. I think it stays on water and you get like the plant is happy. So yeah, just seed, because I noticed that the robins like seed. They don't eat the fat balls and they won't swing from a container. So I leave seed for them on top of the bar so that they can land in, have seed and land out, because I noticed that's how the robins kind of work. And I love the robins because they have a beautiful song. So if I can film them singing like in the garden, or if I can find one of the robins when I put some seed out, I'll try and record them. But my office desk like faces the garden, so when I'm like just daydreaming or like procrastinating, I'll just be looking at the birds. We're on like first name basis, so feed the birds. Let me just have a little sup of tea before I get on to seeds. Okay, seeds. I'm thirsty today. Now, you will notice that I don't have indoor plants. Two main reasons. Mother Nature helps me with the plants outside. So if I forget to water the plants outside, Mother Nature, she rains, or there's just additional help when you have loads of plants outside. So I have kind of mastered the maintenance of outside plants. The reason why I don't have indoor plants is there's no Mother Nature to help me plant water them. I have to remember to do that. And also cats. You have to be so careful with indoor plants and cats and flowers as well. And the girls are really good. Like if I have a bouquet of flowers, they don't bother with them. They don't ingest them. But if you have a curious cat and if they like chew on like a leaf or something, you have to be really careful because a lot of plants are toxic to cats. So I also don't notice many people growing indoor plants from seeds. They normally take cuttings. And when I was in the garden center, I seen like a stand and it was like for indoor plants. And I was like, I'm gonna give it a shot. So I picked up three, and one of them again, I seen on Gardener's World. And it is a living stone plant. And these are by, the three packets of seeds I have are Thompson and Morgan. And the living stone plant I saw on Gardener's World, they had like, this guy had this greenhouse and they look like stones. They actually kind of look like little brains. And that is something that I was just fascinated by them when I saw them, because I was like, how are they breathing? Generally like oxygen and stuff. So I'm gonna have a shot at growing the living stone plants. They have a long, germination, 14 to 85 days and full sun. So they're gonna have to go on the windowsill, which is why I thought I could use these little clay pots and then transplant them on when they got bigger. So yeah, am I too late? Oh, they flower. So you can sow the indoor plants any time of year. And then these will flower in August, September and October. And I don't know how they will flower because they look like little stones. So I'll keep you posted on the progress of them. The other one I got was a Parlour palm. And if I need to research this, if I grow it and I notice the cats are at it, and I'll just pass it on, I'll gift the plant to like one of my friends. My friend Karen is mad for the indoor plants lately, so I'll just pass them on. And these are, yeah, you can sow these any time of year. So don't worry about, because I know the outdoor plants, you kind of have to be sowing now up until May and then putting them outside. And then the last thing I got is painted needle. I like the foliage of this and I just thought the foliage would be nice maybe for like flower displays. Yeah, so the foliage, it has kind of like burgundy kind of colouring on it. I just, yeah, it was the foliage that kind of drew me to it. Germination is quicker on this one, 10 to 20 days for germination. And yeah, full sun, part shade. So anything indoor plant has to be, you'll notice it's nice and sunny here today. So my seedlings are on the window. I've got dahlia and delphiniums on the window. So I have to have anything houseplant in the back of the house because this, or upstairs, because the sun doesn't go into the living room, only in the morning, and then it's in shade. So a nice sunny kitchen. So I'm hoping maybe I will keep you updated on the progress of the indoor plants, but let me know if you have planted indoor plants from seeds. So now we are on to the plants. I wasn't gonna buy any more plants, but then when I was there, I was like, oh, that's pretty. Oh, that's pretty too. And sure luck, I came out with a few plants, but they will add to the garden. So I have a little, oh no, one of them is drooping because I kept them in last night. There was frost. This poor little ranunculus, I'll have to pot him. Look, I've already started killing him. I haven't, he just needs to go out to the sun. Is he dry? Yeah, he just needs a drink and some sun and he will, yeah, he just needs a drink and he'll be grand. They just need to go outside. I left them on the kitchen table overnight. So I got myself three ranunculus. These would look really cute in little pots as well, but I'm gonna put the three of them in the really long terracotta pot. And I just think they're so pretty. They're really nice in cut flowers as well, but they're nice just to have in your garden. And I think it's another plant to have for that springtime. Like in Ireland anyway, these I'd say will come into flower April, May, June. I know they're in flower in the garden centres now, but you'll notice when you put things into your own garden, it all depends on the light and like the external conditions compared to greenhouses. But I just thought, because I have alliums coming up, I'm always looking for plants that will fill in gaps. So when the daffodils and the tulips are starting to die off, it's nice to have colour with other plants. And these are a mid-spring to summer flower. So I thought I would give them a bash. So I just got myself three ranunculus, a cream, an orangey, and a nice pink. And I thought they'll look cute in the terracotta pot. The three of them planted together, looking sunny and happy. The next plant I got four of them. And the reason I got them actually, so I got them in like different varying colors. I have like a cream one, I have a pink one, a dark pink one. I've got like medium tone pink, and then yeah, I have another one of the same. These are actually rock plants, and I was like, that means if I put them in a clay pot and I forget to water them, they may forgive me. Another big reason why I got these was because anytime I see a bee or a butterfly symbol on the little label, I'm like, sold, sold. So the bee buckets that I grew last year have come back. I thought they were only annuals. I didn't know they were going to come back. And the bee buckets have come back. And when there was a bit of nice weather, it's gone cold now, but I was sitting out in the garden and all of the big bees, like the big huge ones that, I don't know if they come out of their nest for food, they were in the garden. And I haven't seen any butterflies yet, but I know it was last year I had so many butterflies from planting the bee and butterfly mix. So these are bee friendly, and there's a picture of a butterfly. So they are, what am I? I can't pronounce the Latin. Saxifraga. No? Saxifraga. Saxifraga. And they'll tolerate minus 25. Like, that's the sort of stuff we need. Can adapt to sun or shade, fully to half hardy, give them moist, well-drained, alkaline soil of moderate fertility, and they should do quite well. So I got four of these. I'm gonna pop them in pots for my plant stand. And another reason why I bought these was because of the flower. I have like a flower subscription with like a girl in Dublin. And I get flowers like delivered once a month. It's like my tree. And she does lovely bunches. Bouquet Box is the name if you are in Ireland. She delivers like nationwide. But I noticed a couple of times when I've gotten, I don't know if this is the flower that's in the bouquet, but there's a lovely little like dainty flower in the bouquet sometimes. And I'm like, what is that? And a lovely like foliage. So it reminded me of those bouquets and I was like, I want them in my garden. So I think you could, if you're doing like, you know, those living walls where you have like loads of mosses and stuff, I think this is the sort of plant that does really well. So I'm hoping they'll be happy in a clay pot. I'm gonna give them like a little bigger pot so they'll grow bigger. So I got 4 of them. Oh, you know what? I need to pause and give my poor little ranuncula a drink before it dies. I do feel so guilty. It'll be back, don't worry. So last on my plant list, again, I went in to get terracotta pots and I came out with this. I have no self-control in the garden centers. I got a tray of stocks because beautiful for cut flowers and the bees love them. So there's like a little bee symbol on this, and this is a mixed, so I'm not sure what color they're going to be. I'll let you know what like they kind of come up as. I planted some snapdragons in the garden last week, so I'm thinking, I wonder if I have room, I might mix them in with the snapdragons. I know they grow quite tall, so I need to kind of see, but if not, we'll have a little pot for them. I could put them in the border up the front. But the shade, full sun to partial shade, I'd have to find a sunny spot for them if I did put them in the flower bed. But if not, they can go into a pot. Yeah, so I'm gonna get these little guys into the soil. So a mixed bunch of stocks because they just look beautiful in flower range. And I think you can dry them as well, or you can press them. Yeah, pressing them. Then I got a bunch of strawberries. I could have totally grown them from seed, but I actually didn't see any seed when I was there. Another thing I didn't notice, I was looking for dahlia bulbs because I've grown dahlias from bulbs. I couldn't, any of the places I've been, I could not see the bulbs. So I'm doing seed instead, and they're on the windowsill. So I just got a tray of strawberries because you can actually put strawberries in like hanging baskets, but I think I'm gonna put them. The reason why I bought these actually was because my niece and nephew will love these, and I might actually like just plant maybe 4 and make a little pot for my niece and nephew, like a bigger one for the other 2 strawberries, because last year I gave them peas. I had some extra pea like seeds that I had grown, and I gave them to them, and they love the whole like watching it grow. So I think I might do the same and give them a strawberry plant each, and yeah, see how they get on with it, because like it's good fun when they can kind of pick and eat as well. Yeah, I picked these up. I think they're only €6. Yeah, they weren't too expensive. And also, actually, there's a little bee symbol on the end of this. So I have bought, like, the bees are gonna love me. Keep the bees pleased. So that is everything I picked up in the garden center. I was saying actually on like an Instagram like during the week that, and a few people were kind of feeling the same, that the drive this year for the garden is not as like full steam ahead as we were last year. I know last year, I don't know if it was kind of novelty. I don't like the word novelty, but like it was our escapism. And I think this year we're all fatigued. So don't be so hard on yourself if you are like, I have seeds and I haven't planted them, because some of my friends were saying the same as well, that, you know, last year they were gusto and the fascination of the garden, whereas this year they're just feeling a bit like, you know, sluggish. Like the power wash and the pots is not doing it for them like it did last year. And you know what? That is okay, because I think we're just all fatigued. Regardless of where you are in the world, whether your restrictions are lifted, whether you're still in the thick of it, I think we're all just fatigued. You know, I know I am. But I did get a little buzz. I actually have to ask you guys a question about my seeds. I did get a buzz seeing the seedlings open on the window. I had forgotten. I was like, oh yeah, there's the buzz. And I'd love a greenhouse. I'd love, like, my windowsills get packed, and I think that's what stops me from growing. But I need to, even if I get like a cheap, actually Karen again, she has this, she calls it her Wendy house. She's just got like a cheap like stand. It's like one of those little mini greenhouses that you just zip up, and it's like overflowing with seedlings. And I'm like, maybe if I just even get like something like that to tide me over, or like a recycled one or a DIY one. But seedlings, I have a question. So first of all, I didn't label. I planted last week, a full week ago, a tray of dahlias and a tray of delphiniums. One tray has germinated, like, well, when I say germinated, we've got like the shoot, you know, when it opens. But this tray is dead. Well, it's not dead. There's none of the seeds, like there's no signs of any germination. And somebody said during the week that they had the same thing and it was dahlias. So if this is a tray of dahlias, do dahlias take ages to germinate from seed? So if you are growing dahlias as well, and I know what you're saying, just Google it, but you know yourself, the internet is so overwhelming with knowledge that, you know, one of you guys might be able to point me in the right direction, because I do have a feeling that the other seed tray is delphiniums, because Karen has a delphinium in her Wendy house and it's flying. So I have a feeling that these are dahlias. Now, the good thing about dahlias is they don't kind of flower, or they kind of come into action mid to late summer, and you get them right the way till the first frost. So I would love to know if you are growing dahlias from seed and if they're taking forever to germinate. Like, I'm going to put them back on the window. Like, the other lads are doing well, so I don't think it's the conditions in the house. But anyway, dahlias, let me know. That is me for this video. I am going to make myself a fresh brew of tea, and I think I'm going to spend an hour or two getting my hands dirty. There's nothing like that gardener's hand. It reminds me of being a kid when, like, your dad's hands would have, like, it would just be like full of clay. It was just like and when I'm in the garden and I have like the same like grass stained like mucky hands, it's just like, yeah, literally getting your hands dirty. That's probably where that phrase comes from too. Let me know if you have planted anything, or if you're having any luck with seeds, or you're doing any seed swapping, or what your kind of garden plans are, and if you've been able to get to the garden centre to treat yourself to some nice pots. On Monday, actually, we are allowed out of the 5K area, and we have the county back. So we have, it means I can go anywhere in Dublin, not just my 5K. So I'm looking forward to that. I'll still obviously, you know, be getting, you're not allowed to meet up with people, I don't think. I actually don't know what the rule is. All I know is you can get out of your 5K on Monday and stay in the county. So I'm happy with that. But you know what that means? That means more garden centres. So I may get another pot or two, but we'll see. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this week's video. Give it a cheeky thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I'll see you all in the next one.